The first 100 minutes. The detonation of the radiological dispersal device may produce radioactive ballistic fragments that can give off radiation. In this example, the dangerous radiation zone around the fragment is shown in dark purple. The hot zone is shown in light purple. The detonation may also produce radioactive smoke. In an urban environment, this smoke can be carried in several different directions and may be a respirable hazard for those in the area within the first 15 minutes after the detonation. The smoke may also contaminate surfaces downwind, possibly causing elevated radiation levels. This simulation tracks the responders' exposure from all of the radioactive fragments and smoke contamination. The exposure rate at the responders' location is shown by the top number and represents what would be seen on a handheld instrument. This guidance uses the following hazard zone definitions. The hot zone is any exposure rate greater than 0.01 R per hour, or 10 milliR per hour. This zone can be safely operated in by responders for life-saving and property protection activities, provided that unnecessary activities and time spent in this zone is minimized. Naming conventions for this zone vary, consult your local doctrine. The dangerous radiation zone is defined as any area greater than 10 R per hour. Activities in this zone should be restricted to time-sensitive, mission-critical activities such as immediate life-saving, and should be performed as rapidly as possible. The total dose received by the responder is shown by the bottom number. In the United States, occupational workers typically have an annual dose guidance of 5 rem per year. There are no dose limits for emergency response activities. Provided that all reasonable dose reduction actions have been taken, a 10 rem dose is justified for property protection, and a 25 rem dose is justified for life-saving activities. Again, these are not limits, and higher doses can be justified for the protection of large populations, when the responder is fully aware of the risks involved.